DeRay McKesson rose to national prominence as an activist after Ferguson. But before that...
I lived at 5th and Marquette. I was a senior director of Minneapolis Public Schools.
Now, after the MPD killing of Amir Locke just blocks from his former home, McKesson will advise the city on its no-knock warrant policy, following the mayor's decision to temporarily ban them.
Are we seeing some momentum building across the country when you're looking at other cities and states implementing these sorts of rules?
There was changes in Pittsburgh, in St. Louis, in Birmingham.
According to his group Campaign Zero, six states and a handful of cities have banned or restricted no-knock warrants. It all started in Louisville, which passed Breonna's law in June 2020, just a few months after police killed Breonna Taylor during a raid.
That was a tragic time.
David James is the president of the Louisville Metro Council and a former police officer.
How has it worked so far in your city?
I've not heard any complaints from law enforcement about it.
But it wasn't always an easy sell.
The police at that time were saying, well, we can't do no-knock warrants. We can't ever catch criminals. And so we really talked through that.
Ultimately, Louisville banned no-knock warrants and placed restrictions on all search warrants.
And the warrant type doesn't matter as much as people think it does.
Following their work with Louisville, McKesson and a criminal justice expert will now turn their attention to consulting Minneapolis.
So I'm hopeful that as we start engaging with the mayor and his team, that I think that they can get to a solution.
The Minnesota DFL will also be talking about a no-knock ban tomorrow, and while the fate of that proposal would be unclear in the Republican-led Senate, there are several GOP legislators who've said they're open to reviewing these policies. Danny Spiewak, CARE 11 News.